Sy hoop wat ons nader aan God bring, wat ons in die begin gelees, vir eens was julle ver van God af weg, maar nou deur die wat, deur die bloed van Jesus, word ons baan nabij aan God gebring. So dit sê die eerste hoop, the first hope, weren't good enough. The law made nothing perfect. We couldn't make it through the law. But it says, but now a better hope is introduced, which brings us close to God. Who's that hope? Colossians 1 verse 27. I'm reading all the scriptures just because I want to prove it to you. Colossians 1 verse 27. Let's start at verse 26. Colossians 1 verse 26. It says, the mystery of which was hidden for ages and generations from angels and men, but is now revealed to his holy people, the saints. Verse 27. To whom God was pleased to make known how great for the Gentiles are the riches of the glory of this mystery, which is Christ within and among you. The in capital letters, the hope. If it's in a capital letter, it means it's a person. Who's our hope? Jesus. If you say, I've lost hope, it means you've lost Jesus. Let's read again. To whom God was pleased to make known how great the Gentiles are the riches of the glory of this mystery, which is Christ within us, within me and within you. Dis Christus in ons, which is the hope of realizing the glory. God said, the Bible says that we all be glorified when Christ, with Christ when he comes. Glorified. It means glory is light. Amen. It's like light shining. It's a glory. In the Holy of Holies, the glory was the light shining in that perfect in the Holy of Holies, beyond the veil. Now that light, the Bible says, is inside of us, illuminating every person. So the more I'm looking to the face of Jesus, the more hope I get of becoming like him. 1 Timothy 1 verse 1. Paul, an apostle, a special messenger of Christ Jesus, by appointment and command of God our Savior, and of Christ Jesus our hope. Read it again. Hope, once again, capital letter. Paul, an apostle, a special messenger of Christ Jesus, by appointment and command of God and Savior, and of Christ Jesus the Messiah, who is our hope. So Timothy must have read all the letters of Paul, must have studied it, and realized that there's a hope. There's a hope that all of us have. But if we lose hope, we lose vision, we lose the promises of God, and we fall back, and we're not able to resist the devil, we're not able to stand anymore, we lose the will of life, we lose the joy of life. But then suddenly something happens and Jesus comes and he says, I've done everything for you on the cross. Don't look into the law, the old covenant anymore. But turn around. The devil will tell you, will use the law to tell you you're not good enough. Don't believe the lies. Don't believe the lies of the devil, but let yourself turn around. Turn around in your heart. Turn around in your mind and start believing my words. And when we do it, we look into the face of Jesus and suddenly a hope jumps up into our heart because he is our hope. What is the hope we have? It is to become more like Christ. Paul said, Christ in us and around us, amongst us, which is what? The hope of glory, of realizing the glory. So this is a very simple word today, but if you understand it, when you come into a situation and you feel depressed or you feel stressed, suddenly you have to say, but I cannot lose hope, because if I have Christ, I have hope. Why? Because he is my hope. In every situation, he is my hope. Ek het dan nog lang terug toe bedien Latanya. Latanya het gesê, ons het geen rede om depressief te word. Ons het geen rede om hartseer te wees. Ons het geen rede om te stres of om vrees te hê nie. Ons het geen rede nie of om angstig te wees nie. Want ons het Christus. And today the Lord just spoke to me this morning. He said, but you have hope. Tell the people that they must have hope. Who is hope? We must have Christ. He is your hope. Hebrews 6 verse 18. Now hear what it says here. This was so that by two unchangeable things, his promise and his oath. So it says that there's two things that's unchangeable in the world, in the universe. Is God's promise and his oath, his agreement that he has with you, his inheritance that he has with you. It's unchangeable. And God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. But it says that there's two unchangeable things, is God's promises. His promises cannot change. If God gives you a promise, he will not change it. It will always be there. I said a while ago, if you feel that you've done something wrong in your life and you will no longer receive the promise that God promised you, then you make a mistake. And I asked the Lord, but how can we, if we've done something wrong, how can we still get to the point where we can reach what you always had for us, what you always promised in our lives? And one day the Lord showed it to me as I was driving in my car. I took a wrong turn and my GPS said, recalculating. And the Lord said to me, at that moment, the Lord said, that's how I am. If you've done something wrong in your life, if you make a wrong turn, I'm not going to take away your destination. I'm only going to give you a different route to that destination. It might take you a bit longer. It might even be a bit quicker. But if you've made the wrong turn, my grace will come and forgive you and still take you to your destination. But it would only, my grace will only say recalculating. Of make a U-turn. Dit is God se genade werk. Sy belofte kan nie verander nie. Dit bly altyd dieselfde. It's two unchangeable things in which it is impossible for God to ever prove false or deceive us. So it says God will never be false to you, and he will never deceive you if he gives you a promise. We who have fled to him for refuge might have mighty indwelling strength and strong encouragement to grasp and hold fast the hope of becoming like Christ, appointed for us and set before us. Now, here it says in verse 19, now we have this hope as a sure and steadfast anchor of the, what? Soul. Where do we need to be saved? We need to be saved in our soul. Where do we wear the helmet of salvation, of being saved? In our soul. But now we have the promise from God, which is like an anchor. I'm not going to draw it to you. I'm going to do it just now. Let's just quickly read on. I'm going to maybe even close with the scripture. It says, now we have this hope, who is Christ, becoming like Christ, as a sure and steadfast anchor of the soul. It cannot slip and it cannot break down under whoever steps upon it. A hope that reaches farther and enters into the very certainty of the presence within the veil, where Jesus has entered in for us in advance, a forerunner, having become a high priest forever in the order of Melchizedek. And I wanted to see this. The throne room of God, it was always the holy of holies and the outer court and the inner court. You all remember that? So let me draw it like this. It was always in three stages. It was the outer court, then the inner court, and then it was the Holy of Holies in the Old Testament. So the people could never come into the Holy of Holies, they would die. So the high priest had to sprinkle himself with blood, and then only could he come in. But there was a veil, there was a laken wat hier gehang het. So this veil stopped that no one could look into the glory of God. And Moses, every time when he came in, there was a light shining in the Holy of Holies. It was the glory of God shining. Amen. But now the Bible comes and it says, for we have a hope. Who is our hope? Jesus Christ, which is like an anchor. You're going to understand this, amen? Like an anchor. So why do we need an anchor? If a ship is on stormy seas, what does he need? He needs an anchor to keep himself there. So we say, it says that we have Christ. Let's make a big C here. We have Christ as an anchor, which moves beyond the veil. It means it comes past the veil, this anchor. Amen? It goes into the presence of God, and it is hooked on. It is anchored in the presence of God. Amen? So we have this hope as an anchor. Let's read on. Read again. Now we have this hope as a sure and steadfast anchor of the soul. So this is an anchor for what? For our souls. Here's the boat. Here's our souls. It is the way I think. It's the way I do things. It's my thoughts. Can you all see? So we have this hope, who is Christ, as an anchor for our souls, and yes, the stormy seas. So he says that your soul, while you are in this world, is always up and down. The waves come, storm comes against where? Against your soul. And every time when you pray, you try and be strong in your spirit because your soul is fading. Your soul is struggling. You're trying to understand why this is happening. And the more you ask why, the more troubled you get. But when you turn around and don't forget about asking why, Here, hoekom het hierdie gebeur? Hoekom daai? En ek kyk in die gesig van mense en ek sê, Jesus, maar ek glo wat u sê. Ek wil hoor wat u sê. Ek kyk na die woord en die woord sê, ek is vry, ek is heilig gemaak. Hoe meer begin ek die water stil maak in my lewe. Maar hoe meer ek vra, Here, hoekom het hierdie gebeur? Hoekom dit? Here, in hierdie en ek wil in my siel, in my gedagtes wil ek alles uitredeneer en ek kan nie. En hierdie water word net nog meer soos 'n storm in my lewe. Sê God, al kom al die storms, even if the enemy comes in like a flood. The Lord will raise up a standard. And our hope, which is an anchor, it says, we are anchored, and if the wind comes, the wind may blow us, and the wind may blow us to this side, the wind may blow us to the left, to the right, but the anchor will not slip and it will not break. The Bible says that this anchor cannot break away from where it is. It will always hold you to be connected to this place where the Holy of Holies, where God is. And the Bible says, where Jesus entered in for us, he went all the way when he died on the cross. He went in and he himself took his own blood, not the blood of an animal. He took his own blood and he sprinkled himself with the blood. And he went into the Holy of Holies where God is in the heavens. And he said, Father, here is my blood for my people. Thank you that you washed him clean, holy, and blameless by this blood that I have. So now whenever God looks at us, he sees us under the blood of Jesus, holy and blameless. But the Bible says, but we have this hope, which is like an anchor. And even the wind comes in our souls, we go to the left, go to the right. We struggle to understand things. He says, even if it feels like your mind is in a storm, don't worry because you are anchored into the Holy of Holies. Which is what? Salvation. Which is what? Becoming like Jesus. Just spoke like a Russian, which is what? Which is what? It's becoming like Jesus. Now, I don't know if you've seen this, but this morning when I prayed about it, the Lord showed me his vision. And he showed me people running around in their thoughts, always feeling not good enough, always feeling guilty, condemned. People losing vision, people losing hope, no longer living life, but just surviving. The Lord showed me this picture of this people, and the Lord said to me, tell the people this morning, everyone, tell them not to lose hope. Because it's unchangeable. You have to understand that this chain, this anchor cannot slip. It cannot break. This anchor went past the veil into the Holy of Holies and is solidly connected to the very throne room of God where Jesus gave his blood as an offering. It cannot slip, it cannot break. Let me read again. Now we have this hope, which is Jesus, as a sure and steadfast anchor of the soul for my seal. It cannot slip and it cannot break under whoever steps upon it. A hope that reaches farther and enters into the very presence of the Lord. 1 Peter 1 verse 3. Just quickly. 1 Peter 1 verse 3. Then we're closing. 1 Peter 1 verse 3. It says, praised, honored, and blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ the Messiah. By his boundless mercy, we have been born again to an ever-living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. Born anew into an inheritance, no longer a covenant, an inheritance. No longer you do, then I will do. It's I've done it, just believe. Born anew into inheritance, which is beyond the reach and change of decay, unsullied and unfading, reserved in heaven from you. Where was decay? From this side, everything was worldly, natural. There was decay. Where was everlasting glory, hope, life in the presence of the Lord? Everything here was perfect. If you stepped into the place, you were healed. You were made complete. And it says here that this hope moved.